If you've ever wondered why sea lions are called the dogs of the sea, here's your answer.
To me, the sea lions are, I don't know, they're just pretty special. There's something about them, you know, they've got an intelligence. But it's the personality, I think, that comes through that, you know, makes you want to hang out with them. The animals are, you know, really what keep us here. It's a lot of fun, like I say, it's like a family up there. We've, you know, been at it for a while, you know them all. It's pretty special.
Beautiful. Aww. It's unreal, isn't it? This film is called Eyre and Sea and was created by filmmaker Jem Cresswell, who joins us now. Jem, this is beautiful. These pictures, Alan, where was this filmed and what's his story?
So basically, I met Alan quite a few years ago and he lives in Baird Bay, which is in the middle of the Great Australian Bight. And it's about 45 minutes off the highway and there's actually only three people that live in that town. You've got to drive on the beach, actually, to get to his house.
Wow. How did he become so connected to the sea lions?
Well, I guess he actually went to that town to retire and, yeah, it was sort of bought a fishing license that was just going to sit out in the sea and sort of fish for a living and sort of just take some time out and then sort of began sort of seeing the sea lions, swimming with the sea lions and...
Named them as well, hasn't he? Barry and Beryl.
Yeah, and now taking people on tours swimming with the sea lions. So,
Wow. Yeah,
it's quite amazing to see his life there in such a remote place shaped by these incredible creatures. Yeah.
What a story.
What's the state of the sea lion population here in Australia? Are they in trouble?
At the moment, their numbers are actually declining. They've been declining for a long time. Over the last four decades, they're actually down 60%. So, yeah, it's not looking good at the moment. Several sort of factors have been sort of mitigated, but still further research is needed. Mm. And, yeah, important research is ongoing at the moment.
Yeah. But, if you look closely around the Sydney Opera House, there's one little lonely sea lion that pops up every now and then, which is kind of bizarre to see one in Sydney Harbour. You were underwater with these incredible creatures. Did they just swim up to you like that? Were they really curious about you or were you worried that they were looking at you going, I wonder what he tastes like?
No. When I jumped in the water, I was sort of wondering what it was like to film them and how close I could get. But they're so curious, they kept coming up too close, putting their nose on my mask and putting their nose on the camera all the time. So it was actually, I needed them to be a little bit further away whilst I felt like...
You're ruining my shot, guys.
Yeah. Whilst I felt like they were looking at me, they were just actually looking at a reflection of themselves in the front of the car.
Yeah. That's what it is. Like
narcissist.
We all do.
Totally narcissistic.
You also photographed humpback whales for your book, Giants. I remember seeing an exhibition of yours in Sydney here and I thought it was fantastic. You shot the book in Tonga and said it was a journey of growth.
Yep.
In what way was that?
I guess for me, sort of, I went over there with this idea of could I capture portraits of whales that would make you sort of feel an emotion as if you were looking at the portrait of a person, and sort of a play on anthropomorphism. And I guess over the projects, it was now 7 years throughout that project, swimming with families of whales. Just, I guess for me, that journey and sort of... taking that time out and pushing those ideas as far as they could go. It was a great learning journey for me.
I know you came at it as a filmmaker through the lens of a camera, but when you kind of took your eye away from that, were you like, holy heck, this is an animal the size of a bus swimming next to me. Was it frightening?
I guess at the start it was. When a creature comes up towards you that's 16 metres long, you're sort of like, is it going to move? Am I going to move? Yeah. But... yeah, they're so aware of their size. They're such a conscious creature. And you do get addicted to these underwater moments. If you ever want to feel small, insignificant and very humble, swim with a humpback whale.
Wow. It's a game of chicken I don't want to play.
Yeah. Eyre and Sea is being screened as part of the Ocean Film Festival. You can head to oceanfilmfestivalaustralia.com.au for details. Jem Cresswell, thank you so much for sharing those incredible pictures and your story.
No worries at all. Thanks for having me.